नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवी एंड डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ शालाकीय तंत्र फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ यूनिवर्सिटी। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस द कंजक्टिवाइटिस। सो व्हाट इज कंजक्टिवाइटिस? इट इज द इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ कंजक्टिवा, इज नोन एज कंजक्टिवाइटिस, और इट कैन बी डिफाइंड एज कंजक्टिवल hyperemia associated with a discharge, which may be watery, mucoid, mucopurulent or purulent. So then the classification of types of conjunctivitis. So if we see the etiological classification, it can be infective conjunctivitis or allergic conjunctivitis, secretory conjunctivitis and the toxic conjunctivitis. The infective conjunctivitis has again been classified as the bacterial conjunctivitis, chlamydial conjunctivitis, viral conjunctivitis, ophthalmia neonatorum, granulomatous conjunctivitis. And the second type of conjunctivitis, which is the allergy conjunctivitis, can be again classified as the simplex conjunctivitis, vernal conjunctivitis, atopic conjunctivitis, giant papillary conjunctivitis, canular conjunctivitis, contact dermoconjunctivitis. The third type of conjunctivitis, which is called the secretory conjunctivitis, can be classified as the ocular mucous membrane pancytoid or the toxic epidermal necrolysis. It can be Stevens-Johnson syndrome and the secondary secretory conjunctivitis. Now, the whole chart shows the classification of conjunctivitis. First of all, we will study the infective conjunctivitis. So, infective conjunctivitis is the inflammation of conjunctiva caused by the microorganisms. It is of the commonest variety. So, the natural protective mechanism of the conjunctiva is in the form of low temperature due to the exposure to air. The conjunctiva has a physical protection by lids. Conjunctiva has a flushing action of tears. And there is the antibacterial activity of lysozymes. And there is the humoral protection by the tear immunoglobulins. So there is a natural protective mechanism. Still, the conjunctiva can be infected by the various microorganisms. So, first type of infective conjunctivitis is the bacterial conjunctivitis. There has occurred a relative decrease in the incidence of bacterial conjunctivitis in general, and those caused by gonococcus and cornebacterium diphtheria in particular. However, in developing countries, it still continues to be the commonest type of conjunctivitis. It can occur as sporadic cases and epidemics. The outbreaks of bacterial conjunctivitis epidemics are quite frequent during the monsoon season. Then the etiology of bacterial conjunctivitis. They have the predisposing factors, the causative organisms, and third is the mode of infection. So the predisposing factors of bacterial conjunctivitis, especially the epidemic forms, are the flies, poor hygienic conditions, hot dry climate, poor sanitation, and the dirty habits. These factors help the infection to establish as the disease is highly contagious. Then there are the causative organisms of bacterial conjunctivitis. It can be caused by a wide range of organisms in the following approximate order of frequency. First is the Staphylococcus aureus. It is the most common of bacterial conjunctivitis and blepharoconjunctivitis. Second organism is the Staphylococcus epidermis. It is an innocuous flora of lid and conjunctiva. It can also produce blepharoconjunctivitis. Third is the Staphylococcus pneumoniae. Pneumococcus produces the acute conjunctivitis and usually associated with the petechial subconjunctival hemorrhages. The disease has a self-limiting course of 9 to 10 days. The next organism is the Streptococcus pyogenes. Hemolyticus is virulent and usually produces the pseudomembranous conjunctivitis. Next organism is the Haemophilus influenza aegypticus. It is also known as the Cockweed bacillus. And it basically classically causes epidemics of mucopurulent conjunctivitis known as the red eye, especially in the semi-tropical countries. Next bacteria is the Moraxella lacunata. It is also known as the Moraxella Axenfeld bacillus. It is the most common cause of angular conjunctivitis and the angular blepharoconjunctivitis. Next organism is the Pseudomonas pyogenia. It is a virulent organism which readily invades the cornea. Next organism is the Neisseria gonorrhoeae. It typically produces the acute purulent conjunctivitis in adults and ophthalmoneonatum in newborn. It is capable of invading the intact corneal epithelium. Next organism is the Neisseria meningitis or meningococcus. It may produce the mucopurulent conjunctivitis. Next bacteria is the Cornebacterium diphtheria. It causes the acute membranous conjunctivitis. Such infections are rare nowadays. Then next is the mode of infection. Conjunctiva may get infected from three sources: the exogenous infections, the local surrounding structure, local spread, and endogenous by the following modes. First is the exogenous infections, which may spread directly through the close contact as airborne infection or as waterborne infections. In exogenous infection may also spread through vector transmission, for example, flies, or through the material transfer, such as the infected fingers of doctors, nurses, common towels, handkerchiefs, and infected tonometers. Then, second mode of infection is local spread, which may occur from neighboring structures such as infected lacrimal sac, lids, and nasopharynx. And in addition to these, a change in the character of relatively innocuous organisms present in the conjunctival sac itself may cause infections. Third mode of infection is endogenous infections. They may occur very rarely through blood, for example, gonococcal or meningococcal infections. Then comes the pathology of the bacterial conjunctivitis. The pathological changes of bacterial conjunctivitis consist of the vascular response. It is characterized by congestion and increased permeability of the conjunctival vessels associated with perforation of capillaries. Then there is cellular response. It is in the form of exudation of polymorphonuclear cells and other inflammatory cells into the substantia propria of conjunctiva as well as the conjunctival sac. Then the next pathological change is the conjunctival tissue response. The conjunctiva becomes edematous. The superficial epithelial cells degenerate, become loose, and even desquamate. There occurs proliferation of basal layers of conjunctival epithelium and increase in the number of mucin-secreting goblet cells. Then fourth pathological change is the conjunctival discharge. It consists of tears, mucus, inflammatory cells, desquamated epithelium cells, fibrin, and bacteria. If the inflammation is very severe, diapedesis of red blood cells may occur and discharge may become blood stained. Severity of the pathological changes varies depending upon the severity of inflammation and the causative organisms. The changes are thus more marked in the purulent conjunctivitis and mucopurulent conjunctivitis. Then comes the clinical types of bacterial conjunctivitis. Depending upon the causative bacteria and the severity of the infection, bacterial conjunctivitis may present in the following clinical forms: the acute bacterial conjunctivitis, hyperacute bacterial conjunctivitis, chronic bacterial conjunctivitis, and the angular bacterial conjunctivitis. These clinical types of bacterial conjunctivitis we will discuss in the next session. Thank you so much. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it soon. थैंक यू सो मच स्टूडेंट्स. डॉक्टर विच इज द वन थर्ड ऑफ द टोटल रिफ्रैक्टिव पावर ऑफ द आई सॉरी द इट इज द 3/4 ऑफ द टोटल रिफ्रैक्टिव पावर ऑफ आई दैट इज द टोटल रिफ्रैक्टिव पावर ऑफ आई इज 60 डायोप्टर एंड दैट ऑफ कॉर्निया इज 45 डायोप्टर. Then the histology, there are 6 layers, anterior epithelium, Bowman's membrane, central stroma, Duwa's layer, Descemet's membrane, endothelium. You can see in this image the epithelium, Bowman's layer, stroma, Duwa's layer, Descemet's layer and endothelium. First the epithelium, the corneal epithelium is stratified, squamous and non-keratinized. It is continuous with conjunctival epithelium at limbus but having no goblet cells. Thickness is 50 to 90 micrometer, consists of 5 or 6 layers of nucleated cells resting on a basal lamina, namely the basal cells, wing cells and the surface cells. The basal lamina is secreted by the basal cells. It is 0.1 to 1 micrometer wide. Ultrastructurally, it is distinguished in two parts, lamina lucida and lamina densa. Lamina lucida is superficial, lamina densa is deep osmophilic. Then epithelial turnover, the early study suggested that the epithelium replaced approximately weekly by division of basal cells and the older shell from the surface. It is now recognized that the germinative region lies at the limbus. The stem cells and the cells migrate at a very slow rate to the center of cornea, which may be as long as the ear. Second layer, the Bowman's membrane, it binds the corneal stroma anteriorly with basement membrane of epithelium. It is not a true elastic membrane. Once destroyed, does not regenerate, shows considerable resistance to infection and injury. Third layer is the stroma, which is 0.5 mm thick. The stroma substantia propria occupies about 90% of the total corneal thickness, composed of corneal collagen fibrils, keratocytes and extracellular ground substances. The lamellae are arranged in many layers, 200 to 250, and are parallel to each other. The anterior one-third stroma has a lamella are thin, and in the posterior two-third of the stroma, the lamellae are larger. Next layer is the Duwa's layer, which was discovered by Dr. Harminder Singh Duwa at the University of Nottingham in 2013. It is a fourth layer, which is 15 microns thick. It is a strong layer and impervious to air. Fifth layer is the Descemet's membrane. It is a strong homogeneous layer. It is a basement membrane of endothelium made up of the collagen and glycoproteins. It is elastic. It can regenerate. It has a resistance to chemical agents, infection, and pathological processes. The peripheral rim of Descemet's membrane is the internal landmark of the corneal limbus. And also it is the anterior limit of the trabecular mesh, which is called the Schwalbe's line. Then the last layer is the endothelium. Corneal endothelium is a simple squamous epithelium. Endothelial cells are hexagonal, which forms a continuous mosaic pattern best seen in specular microscopy. Cell density at birth is 6,000 cells per micrometer square, and in young adults 2,500 to 3,000 cells per square millimeter. The endothelial cells cannot divide or replicate. With aging, the cell density of the endothelium decreases, which is compensated by an increase in the cell size or shape. As these endothelial cells are involved in corneal hydration, they help in maintenance of corneal transparency. The blood supply of cornea. The cornea is a vascular structure. Small loops derived from the anterior ciliary vessels invade its periphery for about 1 mm. Actually, these loops are not in cornea, but in the subconjunctival tissue, which overlaps the cornea. Then the nerve supply of the cornea. Cornea is supplied by the anterior ciliary nerves, which are branches of the ophthalmic division of fifth cranial nerve. After going about 2 mm in cornea, the nerve loads their myelin sheath and divide dichotomously and forms three plexures, stromal plexures, subepithelial plexures, and the intraepithelial plexures. Then the applied physiology of cornea. Primary physiological functions of the cornea are to act as a major refractive medium and to protect the intraocular contents. Then the last point is corneal transparency. It is a result of peculiar arrangement of corneal lamellae, peculiar refractive index of corneal lamellae, vascularity of the cornea, relative state of dehydration, swelling pressure of stroma counters the imbibition effect of IOP, and corneal crystallines, water-soluble proteins of the keratocytes. Thank you so much. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.